Hey Icons, it's the iconic fashion figure back with another video. So you won't be seeing me in this week's video since I'll just be basically walking you through some of the different website builders that are out there for you guys to create your online boutique. This video has been requested by a few different people, so I just wanted to hurry up and get it out there. I do have 10 different options of website builders. Of course, there's a ton more, but these are like the main 10 that I could think of. The only thing is putting all 10 in one video is making the video way too long. So this week's video is going to have 4 because these are like the few that I've definitely worked with. And then I'll show you the other 6 in another video that I'm aware of, but I haven't truly worked with. So it'll be a little quicker to go through that video than this one. So make sure you hit the bell for notifications so you can get notified once the second part to this video is uploaded. So the first one that I'll be starting with is Wix.com, which a lot of you may already know about. And I've mentioned it in a previous video that I've worked with Wix.com before and I had an online boutique on there. So it is doable. Over time, it can become expensive. But starting out, there's usually like a discount code where you can get 50% off. Basically, Wix is a drag and drop type of website where you can create your account on there and then drag and drop all the features that you want on your website. Basically, with Wix, you can have a website up and ready same day, usually within an hour or two, depending on how comfortable you are with creating a website and knowing what you want your website to look like. So some of the features here for Wix.com, it comes with the regular Wix editor that I was just talking about, the drag and drop. And then you can create the mobile website too. So when you're looking at your website from a phone, it looks a little different than on a computer. You can actually create a mobile app too. I had done that before through Wix when I had my website there, which was neat. The only thing is with the Apple Store, you have to pay to have it published in the App Store. So that was the only thing there. I only had it published with Android. Another cool feature with Wix.com is they have this automated website builder for you where you answer a few questions on what you want your website to look like, what your business is about. You pick the theme in the beginning first because they'll have a bunch of templates there and they'll generate like a basic website for you, and then you can go in and update some information. You can add to it, take away things that you don't like, which is neat. But that's just some of the basic features. Of course, there's a ton more. As you can see, I'm scrolling through them all. You'll definitely want to go on their website and take the time and really look through all the features and see if it's something that you need. Of course, if it's not what you need, then we'll move on to the next option. Here, I'm just taking you through a bunch of the different themes that Wix has available to you. There are a ton of them. So you'll just go to the templates and then pick a category that you may be selling in. Since I'm in fashion, I'm going to fashion, which a lot of you may be in fashion, but maybe not, maybe something different. And just go through all the themes that may interest you. Look more so at the layout because the pictures you'll change, the text and all the information on there you'll change to make it your own so it'll look different. You can even change the colors on some of these. But I'll just pick one really quick just to show you what they will look like because you can view them before you actually start editing. So it'll give you an idea of what the layout will look like. This is exactly what your website will look like. You would just go in and make the changes so that way you can customize it yourself. Or you can use that automatic website creator. Pick this theme, put in information about your website, and they'll plug in information about your business. So they'll use this theme but your business information, and in a matter of minutes you'll basically have a full website available to you for your brand. But that's pretty much it. I'm not going to go through too much in theme so that way we can get into the pricing. So for pricing, it goes to the basic website pricing, where basically if you're creating a basic website to put information on the internet, this would be your pricing. But of course, we need an online store. So we want to go to business and e-commerce, which you're going to see in a moment. Those prices are higher than this. Okay, so here's the pricing for those of you that are creating an online store. The most popular plan is $27 a month. Lowest you can get is $23 a month. I don't even remember the pricing being this high when I did it, but it's definitely a lot higher. They're probably trying to keep up with Shopify because this is more like their price range. But again, look out for those coupon codes that they usually throw out during holiday times. We might have just missed one for Memorial Day. But look again, maybe for like 4th of July, there may be a code available. But just go through all the features under those price points and see which one fits your business best. So our next option is Weebly.com, Weebly.com. Basically, same exact concept as Wix.com. The only difference maybe is price point and maybe the themes that you get for the layout of your website. But for the most part, it does the same exact thing where you can create an account and it's a drag and drop website builder to make it easy for you to create your website. The one good thing about Weebly is they are integrated with Square. So you know those little card readers that you can take out and about with you and swipe cards on the go? Weebly is sponsored by Square. They may even be owned by Square. I will have to do research on that because I'm not positive. But all that is connected. So if you have a Square reader and you want to take orders outside of home and off of your website, you can do that as well. But basically here, this is going to take you through all the features that Weebly offers. Maybe you'll notice some that Wix doesn't offer, or maybe you'll see something that is missing that Wix did offer you. So that way it can help you determine which one is better. I will tell you, from the moment I went from Wix.com to Weebly.com, price point was different. Weebly is definitely cheaper unless, again, you get that promo code from Wix.com, so that way that can be probably about the same. But you'll want to pay attention to the features you get for each price point on both websites to see if you're missing something that you would prefer to have on Wix.com or Weebly.com, whichever one works better for your business. Just pay close attention before you pay for it. So now we'll quickly go through some of the themes that Weebly has to offer, so that way you can see if there's anything that's any different from the themes that you see on Wix.com. That may be the decision breaker for you. You may see a theme that you like on one website versus the other that'll fit your business perfectly. Maybe you notice they all look the same and it really doesn't matter, so that might not be your deal breaker. I can tell you for the most part, most of them always look the same. They both offer a ton of different themes that you can get. Wix may offer a little more as far as themes, plus they have that automated theme creator for your brand, like I have mentioned before in the video. So that could be the deal breaker for you, but there's definitely a lot of theme options that you can choose from. So now we're going into pricing, so that way you guys can see exactly what I was talking about. So this pricing is for basic websites, which you can see you can create a basic one for free, but we need online stores since we're selling product. So here you can see that pro plan is actually cheaper than any of the plans that Wix offer, probably like half the cost, but the business plan in the middle is really only $2 cheaper than that most popular plan on Wix.com. So like I said, you just have to pay attention to the features you need, because if you can go with this $12 plan on Weebly, that's a steal for you because it's so cheap compared to Wix.com. But if you need some of these other features in the business plan from Weebly, you'll have to determine, is it worth sacrificing the $2, or does Wix offer you more that you'd rather pay the $2 difference? So just pay attention to all the features in here, or if you even need to go up to a higher plan, which, to be honest with you, on here, The only things you're missing is the real-time shipping and abandoned cart, which abandoned cart you can do through MailChimp. Like if you send out emails there, you can connect it to your store. They'll send out those emails for you. It's the real-time shipping that you'll have to figure out, which there are services that offer that as well. So now we're on to WordPress.org, which is what I use right now. Like I mentioned in my previous videos, it turned out to be a lot cheaper and I can do a lot more with my website. You pretty much have all control when it comes to WordPress.org and what you do with your website and how you create it. So WordPress.org, they do have different themes that you can use to create your website. It basically is a template to help you get started. The difference between WordPress.org and like Wix.com and Weebly.com is that basically in order to build your website, either you need to know how to code a website. I don't know coding, so trust me, you don't have to know it. But if you do, WordPress.org is good for you. Otherwise, you can use plugins. And basically what plugins are, let's compare it to like using a smartphone where you buy the phone and it comes with the basics, but then you download a bunch of apps to be able to do what it is that you really want to do with your phone. That's pretty much the same thing with WordPress.org. You get a template or a theme from WordPress.org, or there's a bunch of other places that have templates you can either buy or they're free and you download them. And then you download your plugins, which would be like your apps on a smartphone. And you put all that together until you have the perfect website that you want for your business. Now, the one other thing that you will need, like I was just showing, is hosting, which I have through GoDaddy.com, which is pretty much all that you have to pay for with. And then there's WordPress.com, which is just like Wix.com or Weebly.com is WordPress's version of buying a subscription that you pay for monthly, or you could pay for, or it's billed yearly. And then it's almost more like a drag and drop. I don't know if it's necessarily drag and drop though. I've never used WordPress.com. But you basically would build it like a Wix.com. You don't have as much control. That's pretty much the difference between WordPress.org and WordPress.com. You don't have full creative control over the website. You have to pretty much go with the templates and then do the drag and drop builder. And then you're also paying for it monthly. Whereas WordPress.org, you're not paying for anything monthly. It's completely free. You just pay for your hosting. Oh, and WordPress.com, it's hosted for you, so you don't have to pay for the hosting. But that's pretty much it. I'm just going to go through some of the themes that are available with WordPress.com really quick, but that'll be it for this week's video. Of course, if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and make sure you come back to next week's video where I'll have part two, and I'll have the other six options that you can choose from. So if you didn't find anything here this week, there's more options for you next week. Or even if you did find something this week, but you just want to see what else is out there before making your decision, be sure to check out next week's video. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, be sure to hit the subscribe button. And until next week, thank you for watching.